Question number 4. Again, this is a long question. So when you face such long questions like this one, we don't want to waste our time reading every single word in it. So we should try to be as efficient and effective as possible by solving these questions correctly while reading the minimum number of statements. Looking at the first line of the question, test implementation and execution has which of the following major tasks? We notice that they ask about test implementation and execution tasks. Looking at the answers, we notice that some options are true and some options are false. Good. So looking at the options, let's start with the shortest option. I'm trying here to minimize the time of reading those kind of questions. Option 4. Determining the exit criteria. This is not actually part of the implementation and execution testing activity. It's actually part of the planning, and control testing activity. So option 4 is wrong. Let's now look at the answers. Options A and C are the ones that have option 4 as false. Good. So we have now down our options for the correct answer to A and C. Now looking at answers A and C, we can see that option 3 is the only option that will help us pick either A or C. Option 1 and 2 will not help us as they are true in both answers A and C. So now we're gonna start reading option 3, verifying that the test environment has been set up correctly. This is actually part of the implementation and execution testing activity. So we have option 3 is true. So the answers that have option 3 as true is answer A. So the correct answer is A. Perfect. We don't need to read 1 or 2. You can go and continue answering the exam. And if you have more time after solving the whole exam, you can come back and confirm your answer by reading the remaining options. So option 1. Developing and prioritizing test cases, creating test data, writing test procedure, and optionally preparing the test harness and writing automated test scripts. This is correct. This is part of the implementation and execution testing activity. Option 2, creating the test suite from the test cases for efficient test execution. Again, correct. This is also part of the implementation and execution testing activity. So our pick is right. The correct answer is A. Question number 5. Which of the following is an advantage of independent testing? So we're going to look for the correct answer and the remaining will be false. Option A. Independent testers don't have to spend time communicating with the project team. This is a wrong statement. Testers should spend time communicating with the project team no matter how independent they are. Option B. Programmers can stop worrying about the quality of their work and focus on producing more code. Again, this is a wrong statement. Programmers should never stop worrying about the quality of their code. They still have to do unit testing no matter who will test after them. Option C. The others on the project can pressure the independent testers to accelerate testing at the end of the schedule. One more time, this is again a wrong statement. Independent testing has nothing to do with adding pressures to the independent testers. The last option, option D, independent testers sometimes question the assumptions behind requirement, design, and implementation. This is true. Actually, this is the whole purpose of independent testing. Independent testers question the assumptions behind requirement, design, and implementation. So the correct answer is D. Question number 6. ACM and IEEE Code of Ethics for Engineers. Certified software testers shall maintain integrity and independence in their professional judgment is related to which ethic? Colleagues, management, judgment, or client and employer? Yeah, Code of Ethics. This is a forgotten part of Chapter 1 of the ISTQB curriculum. The question gives you the definition of one of the 8 Code of Ethics and asks about the title of that code. Well, the answer is right there in front of you in the definition. Certified software testers shall maintain integrity and independence in their professional judgment. So judgment is the correct answer. So the correct answer is C. Question number 7. Reporting discrepancies as incident is part of which phase? This is a simple one. When would we report discrepancies as incident, or in other words, when would we report bugs in the fundamental test process? Of course, we will do that while we are running and executing the test cases or test procedures, which is done in the execution part of the implementation and execution part of the test process. So the correct answer here is B, test implementation and execution. Thank you.